reason why you should not be loved and joined together. I need you to speak now or forever hereafter, would you please? Give this hand to the parent. Reduce this one to the parent. Somebody at that time, I could tell the guests, I was like, go ahead and come in. I know it had to be a part of the order, because I'm outside my house. Marriage is a sacred movement that we gather into before God and his witnesses. Today they're about to witness something that will take place in a few moments that will bear fruit for decades to come. My name is Josh, and I hope before God and his witnesses that you would have yourselves ready for this moment to be family as husband and wife. Let's bow our head and ask you to prepare the end, would you please? Heavenly Father, we come to you in the name of our Lord and Savior. We ask this day that you watch over Josh and Maggie as they enter into holy matrimony, to administer to them, Lord, through them, each one of their friends, guests, and family that are here today, Lord, that you would make your face and shine upon them, and forever and last to keep this covenant for you. Watch over them, Lord, may this be the beginning of many happy days in the life. These things we ask in the name of our Savior. Throughout all time, one thing has stood clear, that God intended for man and woman to be married. He placed Adam into the deep sleep in the Garden of Eden and came down and took a rib. He created one of the greatest creations he had ever created, Josh. And that was Adam, a helpmate. A giver of life, a woman, a wife, a friend, one of the greatest assets you'll find your one to have in this world. As Eve came and became the first of all men, she was so declared by God to be Adam's helpmate. Upon that same covenant made with God, he said that you should forever go forth, living together, loving together, sharing moments of your life together. So today we come before God and his witnesses, and you are going to freely and forever pledge your love to each other as a witness for each other to see, feel, and to hear, and be able to share all the days of your life. You're going to find out that as you go through life, that when you see sorrow in your marriage, if you share that sorrow, it's going to become happy. Burden shall become light. And when you find a joy, even though you may share it, you'll find the joy is going to be double. And the burden of a joy is none. It's just going to be pleasant and uplifting for you both. So today we come and just ask you to fully understand the vows in which you're taking your house process and enter into this thoughtfully, soberly, and reverently, knowing that although what the world has done to marriage, it's still one of the most sacred covenants that God has between his creation and himself. I want you to turn and face each other now. And ask you to listen to these words. So I give you these wedding vows, thinking about them deeply and greatly, knowing that as you are intent, only say these once in your lifetime. For the man or woman that can ask him to Josh, you do promise to take Maggie to be your wedding wife. Love her, hold her, keep her, and cherish her, and only her, above all others, and only her. So long as both shall live. I sure do. Maggie, you take Josh to be your lawfully wedded husband. To love him, keep him, cherish him, to care for him. Put up a bad joke to carry him to the man. Sure. Each other. And when you do self-investigate for this.
take me right.
Be my faulty way of life.
Be my faulty way of life.
To thee I pledge my love.
To thee I pledge my love.
And all of my worldly goods.
And all of my worldly goods.
To you I can have.
To you I shall have.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
The Son.
And the Son.
And the Holy Spirit.
And the Holy Spirit.
I now take thee, Josh.
I beg thee, take thee, Josh.
To be my faulty way of justice.
To be my faulty way of justice.
Have it for hold from this day forward.
Have it for hold from this day forward.
I pledge my eternal love to you.
And I pledge my eternal love to you.
To thee only you.
To thee only you.
I endow my worldly goods.
I endow my worldly goods.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And the Son.
And of the Son.
And the Holy Spirit.
And the Holy Spirit.
I'd like to ask you, God, to take me this moment and consecrate these means by faith. Father, we enter this time in the ceremony when the giving and receiving of the ring has been given to show, Lord, that there is a commitment, that there is a duty bound between Josh and Maggie this day. I pray, Lord, that as the purity of this metal with which these rings were forged is 99.99% pure, so will their love be for one another. I pray that as they examine these rings, Lord, they'll see that there's no beginning, no end. Just as there's no beginning or end ever to the love that they now pledge to each other. Watch over them, forever keep them as your children. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, we pray. They're not like him. Committed him over centuries and centuries to signify what God can do through man and woman. And joining together the two planks to make one, just as you two burned, you enter into this sanctuary building this morning as independent planks. So just volunteer, we will join them together. Number one, forever. And as you put the two candles burning, you will symbolize the joining of not just your families, but the families of each other, becoming one big family, falling in love and caring for your both. Ladies and gentlemen, it's my privilege to be the first ever to be able to introduce to you Josh and Maggie Oliva.
Didn't it say in a program wait to be released row by row? That's like a reading instruction.